Hey everyone, today we are talking all about money. Hey everyone, welcome back. For those of you who are new, my name is Mary Ann and I live in Canada with my husband and two kids, ages 3 and 4. I make videos on simplifying motherhood through easy organization. If you're interested in that type of content, please consider subscribing. I release a new video every single weekend. One of the biggest things we have done to simplify our lives has been to simplify our finances. The second we got our money under control, everything was just so much easier and so much less stressful. So over the last few years, we've come up with like a super simple kind of budgeting routine on how we go about managing our money. I'm going to share with you exactly how we do it. So let's get started. Okay, so things to mention right off the bat. Number one is Scott and I are both paid salary. We both work for like a traditional employer and we are both paid twice per month. We also use cash whenever possible for some of our variable items. So I'll show you in more detail, but we do use cash whenever possible and I have found that really helps with us. Another thing is all of our finances are combined. So I know that's kind of a controversial topic and I know it doesn't work for everyone, but for us, we've joined all of our money. Lastly, I use Excel spreadsheets or number spreadsheets to create our budgets for each year. I know that there's a ton of apps out there and if you have an app and it really works for you, then go with that. If you like to do it on pen and paper, that's amazing too. I'm gonna pull up my computer screen and show you exactly what we do to get started. Okay, so step number one is every single year I go ahead and create a big budget for the entire year. As you can see, I've gone ahead right now and created a 2022 budget just so you give you kind of an idea of how it will look coming up for the new year. So we'll start right at the top here, which is all of our incoming money. So it's pretty basic for us. As you can see, there'll be money for Scott, myself. I have an other category. Last category is what I call baby bonus, which is a super old school term. We get a check every single month from the government, which is basically to support anyone who has children, but you know ahead of time how much you're gonna have for that year. So I just plot that right in when I'm creating the budget. Next, you can see we pop right down into our outgoing list, which unfortunately is way longer than our incoming. All of these numbers I've left from last year, just to kind of give you an idea. So under our expenses or our outgoing money, I've split it into different categories. This first section is our fixed expenses, which are things like, as you can see, our mortgage, our taxes, our internet bill, insurance, and then like heat and hydro, that kind of thing. Netflix, obviously a necessity. And then we have our bank every month and then our cell phone bills, which are joined, and then our benefits. Here in Ontario, we have free healthcare, which is amazing. However, it does not cover things like dental. It doesn't cover anything like if you had physio, certain medications, it doesn't cover stuff like that. Luckily though, Scott and I have plans through work. Mine comes straight out of my paycheck, but with Scott's plan, we have to pay a little bit extra every single month. So that's just what that line is where it says benefit. Next section here is our variable expenses, which are things that we have a little more control over and that tend to vary. So groceries and household, this is a huge category for a ton of people, including us. It's one of our biggest expenses. However, it has gone way down. We used to pay for groceries. We were definitely spending at least $1,100, $1,200 a month. For our current lifestyle, $700 is what we're really comfortable with.
For us, it includes way more than just groceries. Medicine, any kind of small household repairs, shampoo, bug spray. If the kids are going to a kid's birthday party and they need a small gift, we'll put that in there. Say we're going to a pumpkin patch and we want to get a few little pumpkins to have for the house for Halloween. So when we first started budgeting and I created this, I had more categories. I broke it down to like household repairs. I broke it out by toiletries, groceries, because I wanted to know exactly what we're spending and where that money was going. And if you're just starting out budgeting, it is so informative and so interesting really to know where all that money's going and exactly how it's being spent. Now that we're really familiar with what we buy and what we consume every month, we are super comfortable with that number. I can put everything into one category and it makes my life easier, less for me to track.
As you can see, daycare is another big line for us. As of right now, I've put it down to $500 a month. We only have one kid in daycare. Leo is now in school full time, so hopefully that sticks. As you can see, I put a little bit higher for the summer months. This amount can easily go over $1,000 per month. So when I really get down to doing our next year's budget, I'll know more information by then and I can really look into it a little bit deeper. Fuel, we do have separate.
The reason we separate this category is because Scott commutes for work. So our fuel is kind of high, like 275. We have two really small cars and we live in town. So really we don't travel a lot day to day. So we do track that separately just because it is a big amount. When Scott stops having to commute, we might just toss that into our groceries and household category because ideally it will be way, way lower. Okay, so the next two categories, we call it mad money. It's basically our spending money. So as you can see, we get 200 each per month.
So the 200 per month lot, I think to a lot of people that sounds like a lot, and it kind of sounds like a lot to me, to be totally honest. However, that spending money covers a ton of stuff. So any type of extracurricular. So if Scott wants to play golf, if that includes all his hockey registration, that would include if I wanted to go get my haircut or if I wanted to go get my nails done or anything like that, that would all fall under that category. Any type of entertainment. If I wanted to go out for dinner with my friends, it would go under there. If we wanted to do a weekend away, if we wanted to go to a concert or something, any alcohol. And it took us a while to settle on that number. It took us a while to figure this one out. So play around with it. Don't feel like if you set up one budget and it has to stick to that, kind of maneuver around, find what works with you, go back to the drawing board a few times. What I like best about this category is that this money, we at the beginning of every month, we just get this money automatically. I do not care what Scott spends it on. He never asks what I spend it on. It totally reduces how much we have to worry or stress about what your partner is spending money on. But I want to hear, how much do you guys have for your mad money every month? And what does that include? Does that include everything? Do you have a whole nother category for hair? Tell me down below because I am super intrigued on this topic and I want to know how everyone else does it.
So next down below, you will see we have our savings accounts. So up until a few months ago, we had a line in between here, in between savings and variable, and that was our debt payoff. We are, hallelujah, done with our debt. So we've taken that line out. But basically up until recently, after we had paid all of these bills, which we absolutely had to pay, and all of our income, whatever the difference was down below here, all of that went straight to debt. So during those couple of years, we did not put anything into our savings. I know that that is another very controversial topic, whether to save while you're paying off debt. We decided not to, but that's a very personal decision that you can make for yourself. Now that we're done paying off our debt, we have under savings, I've kind of put it under three different categories: savings, RRSPs, and RESPs. Our savings is a general account that just, we put everything in there. So we just save in one big account for everything. So if we're saving for trips, if we're saving up for a car, if we're saving for like a huge home repair, we have to do something like that. And then the other two categories are RRSPs, are the retirement fund here in Canada. And then RESPs is the education fund. So say we want to save money for the kids for their college and university. So at this point, we are completely done our budget. And step number two is to copy and paste this sheet into a new one, which becomes our actuals. So this is where we are going to do our month-to-month tracking. You could easily put both your budget and actuals on one big spreadsheet. And I did used to do that. However, I found that I like the idea of having the actuals on a separate page. So that's how I do it now. So about every 2 weeks, I will go in here and update all of our income. I'll put in any pay that we've got. I will add when we've paid our mortgage and all of our bills and then what we have left over, which in this case, now that we're paid off our debt, whatever is left over is going to go into our savings account. As I mentioned before, for a few of our variable items, we use cash. So for our groceries and household at the beginning of every month, we go to the bank machine and we take out $700 for that. We take out our money for fuel, which Scott takes into his car every month. And then we take out our mad money. As soon as that cash is gone, we are done for the month and we have to wait until the first of the next month to spend more.
We found using cash has been huge, was huge when we were trying to save money and trying to budget. It really does control how much you spend. So is it sort of a pain sometimes? Yes. However, totally worth it in my opinion. So a few final notes to finish off. One is that we do the exact same routine for our savings account.
So you'll see here, I've created a draft 2022 savings budget, which is really simple. We know for sure we have to purchase a car or if we have to make a big purchase for say a trip or something like that, I would have that, all of that information here. And then the same as our checkings account, I just create a second spreadsheet, which includes our actual savings. So then we can track exactly what goes in and out of our savings account.
Lastly, for bank accounts, we have two bank accounts, a checking and a savings, and that is it. I have seen tons of information about having like 10 or 15 or 20 different bank accounts, and there's probably tons of benefits to that. So if that interests you, if you think that would help you, definitely check it out. For us, it is all about simplify, simplify, simplify. So having two bank accounts keeps our life easy. All right, friends, that is it for today. I hope that helps. I hope that inspires you. If you're just starting out, be super gentle on yourself. Talking about money and thinking about money can be super stressful, and I totally get that. Start small, don't overcomplicate it, and just do what you can. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. I could talk about money and budgeting all day. I know it's kind of a taboo topic, so if you feel like you can't talk to anyone, send me a message anytime. If there are any other money-related videos that you would like to see, let me know. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time.